shining any place but there.
Good afternoon, Mr. Neely.
Good afternoon, Tootie.
Any mail from my doll, Bridget Rockefeller?
None. But here's a letter for your brother. Your doll's looking well today.
She's dead.
Nagora.
It happened last night. She had 4 fatal diseases.
And it only takes one. Must be the St. Louis Hospital getting her in.
Excuse me, Mr. Neely, but it's pronounced St. Louis.
I got a cousin, spells it the same way. We call him Louis.
He's not a city, is he?
Well, no.
Is he a saint?
Not by a long shot.
Then there's no comparison. St. Louis is a city and the only one that has a World's Fair. Wasn't I lucky to be born in my favorite city? Good afternoon, Mr. Neely.
Any mail for me?
Just one.
Hey, it's my Princeton catalog. I've been waiting for this.
Did you get plenty of celery, Katie?
About 3 bunches, Miss Smith, and I'm going shopping again on Wednesday.
That'll do just fine. Let's get these in water before they wilt.
Let's get us out of the sun before we wilt.
Picture the opening night, pavilions exploding with light. With banners above, we will welcome the world to this rollicking, frolicking sun. Be a magnificent band, with Sousa and Sophocles.
Like a rainbow of shining cascades.
Anna, Papa,
Agnes,
Rose.
Oh, it's far too hot for any of this. I've got to get back and finish cooking dinner.
Grandpa, you're as bad as the children.
I like my second childhood. It is far more fun than the first. I'm enjoying it immensely.
Mother, I had the most lovely carriage ride with Douglas today.
Douglas? I thought you swore you'd never see him again.
Mother.
Oh, and Rose, don't forget to wash your hair while the water's hot.
No, I won't. Wouldn't start a minor revolution in this household if we had dinner an hour earlier tonight?
Mr. Smith hates to sit down to eat the minute he gets home from the office.
I'm due at my sister's house at 7 o'clock on a family matter.
Something wrong at your sister's?
She's having trouble with her husband, him being a man.
Well, It's all right with me, Kate. Would you like to explain it to Mr. Smith?
Oh, he won't mind, seeing as how tonight's corned beef night.
Looks like we'll be eating dinner a little earlier tonight, Grandpa.
Oh, fine. I'll just take my evening constitutional.
Is it all right?
Yes, it's all right, but I had to tell your poor mother another pack of lies.
Well, Katie, they're only white lies.
A lie's a lie, and dressing it in white don't help it. Now, if you don't mind me asking, just why was a lie in this time? Why do we have to have dinner an hour earlier?
Because Rose is expecting a very important telephone call.
Don't you go blaming your sister again.
Blaming her? We're doing this for her. You know Rose's problem. Warren Sheffield, heir to the Sheffield fortune, has been writing to Rose for 6 months now without one word that even smells of a proposal.
What's that got to do with even an hour earlier?
Warren Sheffield is telephoning her long distance at 6:30.
Long distance?
Yes, from New York City. And if the whole family is sitting in here, she may be loath to say a things a girl's compelled to say to get a proposal out of a man, particularly if that man, unfortunately, is Warren Sheffield.
Personally, I wouldn't marry a man who proposed to me over an invention.
Well, we can't be too particular. Although we love Rose, the brutal fact is that, well, she's not getting any younger.
Esther!
Here's the poor old maid now.
Esther! Esther, he's out there!
John Truitt,
in the yard! On the roof! On the roof!
Go, Katie. Just go. Go.
I told you, Mother, you weren't old enough to be taken off sulfur and molasses this spring.
Don't panic. We have every right to sit on our own front porch.
It's a marvelous summer day, is it not, dear sister?
Heavenly, Rose. Simply heavenly.
It would be lovely to go for a cooling swim. Too bad we have no bows to escort us.
Here, Lady Batty. Have you seen my cat? Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Have you checked the rear terrace, ma petite?
You mean the backyard? I look there already.
Oh, Mama says the two of you better get upstairs and make your beds. And Esther should clean the wash basin where she spattered toothpaste.
I'm going to tie you to two wild horses and let them tear you limb from limb.
Go ahead, get two wild horses. See if I can. Here, Lady Babby. Here, kitty, kitty, kitty.
Oh, my dear, the young can be so.
It's all right, Rose. He's gone. Not very neighborly, I must say.
Why am I inviting him to Long's going away party?
But that's in August.
Be patient, S. The time will fly by.
The moment I saw him smile, I knew he was just my style. My only regret is we've never met, though I dream of him all the while. But he doesn't know I exist, no matter how I may persist. So it's clear to see there's no hope for me, though I live at 5135 Kensington Avenue, and he lives at 5133. How can I ignore the boy next door? I love him more than I can say. Doesn't try to please me, doesn't even tease me, and he never sees me glance his way. And though I'm heart sore, the boy next door affection for him won't display. I just adore him, so I can't ignore him. He'll be strolling by, he'll glance up, never knowing why. He'll happen to see me, I'll happen to smile. He'll draw nearer and nearer still, and we'll both feel a sudden chill. He'll happen to like me and stay for a while, but I'm afraid this dream is made of candles. on this way when I know he will never say, I happen to love you, I happen to care. I just adore him, so I can't ignore him. The boy next
door. Rose, the water's lovely and hot, but now with early dinner and everything, there won't be time. You'll have to wash your hair tomorrow. There's always something.
Why are we eating so early?
Well, you don't want the whole family sitting in here, drinking in every word while a man proposes to you long distance.
Proposes? I don't see why you assume Warren Sheffield is going to propose to me.
Well, why else would he be calling?
Do you know what it cost? I don't even know if I'll be in. My dear, when you get to be my age.
When I get to be your age? Never mind. Agnes, we're eating early.
I can't get hungry till it gets dark.
Dinner's at 5:30. You can eat blindfolded.
Grandpa, look what I got at Hummel's today. It just came in.
Oh, good. We can learn the second course.
Meet me in St. Louis, Louis. Meet me at the fair. Don't tell me the lights are shining any place but there.
For heaven's sake! Stop that screeching!
Sorry, Papa.
That's all! The fair doesn't open for another 10 months. That's all everybody talks about. I wish they'd all meet at the fair and leave me alone.
Hello, dearest. Did you have a nice day?
I lost the case.
Oh, no. You were so sure you'd win it.
I overlooked one thing. The judge is a moron.
Papa, if losing a case makes you so mad, then why don't you stop being a lawyer and be something else?
You're right. Beginning tomorrow, I intend to play first base for the St. Louis Browns. Sorry, Anna, if I was a little bombastic.
That's all right, dear. You'll feel much better after you've had your dinner.
I suppose so. But right now, I'm going to soak in a cool bath for one solid hour.
But that's impossible. Dinner's going to be served in 5 minutes.
5 minutes? It's 5:25. Not 6:25.
Alonzo, we're planning on eating dinner an hour earlier tonight.
The plan has been changed. I'm taking my bath.
We're eating early for Katie's sake. She's got to get to her sister's. Family trouble.
We're going to have family trouble right here. I don't get to take my bath.
Oh, Papa.
Katie has been with us for 10 years. She never asks favors. We don't want to risk losing her.
No, nowadays you can't get a maid for less than $12 a month.
I'm telling you.
Vaughn, now count to three.
One, two. I don't care if we have to pay a maid $15 a month. Dinner will be at 6:30. And if Katie wants to hand in her notice, she can reach me in the bathtub.
Oh dear, now we've upset him for no good reason.
Grandpa, why was Papa so mean about his bath?
He's exhausted from the office. Everybody's been really exhausted.
I love it when Papa yells. It's so exciting. I yelled at Bridget Rockefeller last night.
And look what happened to her.
Maybe we should have told Papa about Warren's phone call.
Your Papa's not supposed to know. It's enough that we're letting him work hard every day to support the whole flock of us.
Oh, no, you don't! You're not putting Margarita in Grandpa's cigar box!
Margarita's mine!
And Papa gave it to me on my birthday, and I told you that you could play with her if you didn't bury her!
Agnes, Tootie, stop acting like hooligans.
Well, I don't want her now. I'm too big to play with dolls anyway. You can have her.
Papa's gonna give you a whale week!
Well, I'm too big for that.
I've a notion to shake you both till your teeth rattle.
No need to shake anybody, Rose. We're a peaceful family. We actually like each other. Don't we? Where did you get that face? The laughing eyes, the careless grace. Put them together, they're quite a sight to see.
Why is your smile so nice that it could melt a cake of ice? You're just the gal to be my pal.
Everywhere I go, everything I do seems to be a big success whenever I'm with you.
We don't think alike, nevertheless we're friends.
We're more single eye. When it's all for one, it's a barrel of fun. Everything we plan makes the morning bright. Every plan I make myself just never turns out right. If this is not the perfect friendship, it'll have to do. Cause I rise and shine when I'm with. I love to spend my time with. Less fun whenever I'm with you.
Everywhere I go, everything I do seems to be a big success whenever I'm with you.
We don't look alike, maybe it's just as well.
But I do like you to this smile in a very short while. Every time we die, couldn't love anymore.
This is not the perfect friendship, it'll have to do, cause
I rise and shine when I win. I love to spend my time with.
Life's fine whenever I'm with you. Every time we dance, all the angels sing. When I dance with someone else, it's still the same. I love to spend my time with. Life's fine whenever I'm with you!
Mama, do you think I'm too young to fall in love?
Too young to what?
To fall in love. What was it like the first time you met Papa?
Oh my, there's not near enough time before dinner for this conversation.
But was it love at first sight?
Well, yes. I never wanted your father to know it, but he was the most charming man I'd ever seen. I took one look and that was that.
But how did you know you were really in love?
There are no words to describe it. There is no way to explain. It is either wrong as anything or right as rain. You will stutter and you will stammer. You will look like you are asleep. You will feel a pain inside. Down deep, but then in a little while the whole world will start to smile. You'll hear a bell so clear and sweet. You'll hear a bell that makes your heart forget to beat.
listen to me carrying on. You'll know it when you know it.
It sounds so perfect. Why am I so confused?
It's difficult to fall in love sensibly.
You'll fall apart, but bit by bit, the broken pieces of yourself will start to fit. Your knees will shake, the earth will quake, a bird will sing.
I know I always say to chew 12 times slowly, but tonight, we can make an exception.
What if I choke and die?
Then I'll be sorry. Katie, I think this is the best ketchup we've ever made. Just needs a little more sugar.
More sugar? It's already too sweet.
Mr. Smith likes it on the sweet side.
All men like it on the sweet side. Too sweet, Miss Smith.
I think it's flat.
You can always put spice in, but you can't take it out.
Too sour?
Just what I told Katie.
Rose, I decided to let Joe and Truett kiss me after Lon's party.
Esther Smith, nice girls won't let men kiss them until after they're engaged. Men don't want the bloom rubbed off.
Personally, I think I've got too much bloom.
Bridget Rockefeller lost all of her bloom. I'm going to have to bury her again tomorrow.
Yippee! Another funeral. I'll be there.
Rose, your father will be down in a minute. I had to eat quickly and get him out of here before Warren comes.
Esther!
Wait, I didn't tell her. She figured it out.
If I'm going to keep lying for your daughter, Miss Smith, I'll have to have more money.
It seems to me one little phone call is causing an awful lot of excitement in this family.
I agree.
Well, maybe someday a man will call you long distance and ask me to marry him.
I doubt it.
Agnes, don't hurt your brother. Now listen, all of you. Not a word of this to your father. He's got enough on his mind today.
Everyone knows but Papa?
Yes, dear. Your father doesn't need to know.
Too sweet?
Too sour?
Too thick.
Oh, Grandpa.
It's way past 6:30.
Maybe Warren's not Pop.
Maybe he found himself a New York City girl.
I wish everyone would stop talking about Warren.
Whoa!
Lord and Master.
Now I remember where I left my other skate.
I hope I haven't held you up. I was just having a relaxing little skate. Right before dinner.
Papa, I'm going to bury Bridget Rockefeller in that lovely cigar box you gave me.
Tootie, remind me to spank you after dinner.
Yes, Papa.
Lord, we thank you for all the bountiful blessings we are about to receive. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Katie, this looks delicious.
Uh-huh.
Well, I know this hasn't been exactly a successful day for any of us. Now, let's all relax and enjoy a nice, leisurely meal. Katie, I'm sorry I wasn't able to eat an hour early.
Don't blame me if the corned beef's an hour tougher.
Tootie, you finished already? Now that's how I like to see you eat. You keep eating like that, you're going. Either I found a spoon, or I've lost some soup. Oh, Katie!
Rose, did you hear that they're having a fashion exhibition at the World Fair? Isn't that exciting?
I just can't stand it that we have to wait 10 months for it to open.
I'll die. I'll simply die.
Katie!
Anyone for dessert?
Dessert? What happened to dinner?
I didn't think anyone would want meat right after wallowing in a steaming hot bath.
Nonsense! I have every intention of enjoying an enormous dinner. Bring in the corned beef. And it wasn't a steaming hot bath! Anna, I think Katie is getting a little...
Well, you have been rather unkind to her, you know.
Unkind? That's ridiculous! I simply took a bath! Ah, here we are. You know, Katie, I could smell that cabbage when I got off the trolley.
Cabbage has a cabbage smell.
Katie, in this house we cut the corned beef. We don't shave it.
Miss Smith, you said you wanted this to go for two meals.
Katie! I'll take that. Hello? What? You'll have to speak louder, please. New York? No, I'm not calling New York. What? What? I'm going to have that telephone taken out.
Alonzo.
Yes, Anna?
Not every phone call is for you.
That one wasn't. Those operators. Katie, take this out into the kitchen and slice it.
Why is Rose crying?
What's the matter with her?
Oh, nothing, Papa. You just ruined her chances of marrying a millionaire, that's all.
What?
Warren Sheffield, heir to the Sheffield fortune, was calling long distance to propose.
Tootie, did you know a long distance telephone call was coming to this house?
The Iceman said a drunkard got shot yesterday. He said the blood spurted 3 feet into the air.
Tootie! Answer yes or no.
Yes, sir.
Agnes?
Yes, sir.
Long? Yes, sir. Well, that's just nice. Anna, I'm curious. Just when was I voted out of this family?
Oh, Lonnie, really now?
Well, what else am I to think? My eldest daughter is practically on her honeymoon, and everyone in St. Louis knows about it but me. In view of the fact that this family refuses to let me in on its little intrigues, I'll handle the telephone in my own way. From now on, I'll take all incoming calls myself.
But Alonzo...
I will not be treated this way in my own house. It's deceitful. It's lacking in respect. It's downright... Rose, you take that.
Thank you, Papa. Hello? Yes, this is Miss Rose Smith. Yes, you may put that New York call through. Hello, Warren. Yes, it's me.
I'm
fine. How are you? Oh, St. Louis is fine. It's a little hot, though. Is it hot there? Yes, it's hot here, too. Yes, I can hear you just fine. Are you speaking now? Oh, you're not? Well, is there anything in particular you'd like to discuss? I said, is there anything special you wanted to ask me? Oh, I don't think I misunderstand what you're going to say, Warren. The connection seems quite clear. Excuse me? And why shouldn't I mention this call to anyone? What did you say?
He said there'd be H to pay if his folks find out he called long distance.
Well, that's strange, Warren. My family's sitting right here, and they don't seem to think a thing of it. We get so many long-distance calls, you know. Perhaps you shouldn't waste any more of your valuable time and money, and... Well, you may have another 36 seconds left, but as it happens, I do have another engagement. In fact, here's Joe now.
Good evening, Joe. Come on in and have a seat.
Well, Warren, whether or not you're back in time for Lon's going away party is entirely your own concern. No, Warren, nothing's wrong. Yes, you may write me tonight if you wish. Do that little thing. Well, I bet you're the only girl in St. Louis that's had a Yale man call her to acquire after her health.
You handled yourself beautifully.
Dinner, anyone?
Ah, meat.
Meet me in St. Louis, meet me at the fair.
Thank you.
John. John Truitt.
Sheffield, old man. Good to see you. I didn't know you were back in town.
There's a certain Miss Smith who's been giving me the runaround.
Hi, y'all.
I don't know if anybody told you, but the party's happening in there.
Why, you must be the new boy in town.
How do you do?
Just fine. Well, come on, honey.
Say, would you do me a favor? Would you put in a good word for me with that impossible sister of yours? You can't speak for yourself in there? With all that going on? I can bring her out here.
Hey, that would be great. Can you swing it?
Leave it to me.
Warren, I thought you were still in New York.
I told you I'd make it back in time for your party.
It must have been very difficult tearing yourself away from all those New York debutantes.
Rose, how many times do I have to tell you? Kill the candle. Not just winsome, not just blind, not just easy on the eye, not just someone who lives, but a raving beauty on you. Not just gentle, not just kind, not just dainty and refined, not exotic or bizarre.
Thank you.
It's lovely of you all to be here tonight to say goodbye and good luck to Lon on his way to Princeton.
And we're all going to miss you like mad.
Thanks for coming, everybody. I'll miss you all, too.
Lon, will you do the calls for the square dance?
Sure, sis.
Skip, skip, skip to my loo. Skip, skip, skip to my loo. Skip, skip, skip to my loo. Put on your Sunday go to me, and I'll take you by the hand. If you will be my dancing partner, we will dance to be the band. So join the promenade and lead the big parade. And if you don't get home at all, your pal will understand.
Forgive me, mother.
I'll never get drunk anymore.
You're a very bad girl, Tootie. It's Lon's fault, really. He teaches her these things.
Oh, the cakewalk doesn't with us.
No. Oh, all right. Anything to keep the peace. Now that you've suggested it, you better be good.
We will.
This one's too big.
Here, try this one. That's fine. We'll need one verse and two choruses.
All right, Bess, would you like an introduction?
Yes, the long one. Now.
Down in the jungle lived a maid, a royal blood and dusky shade. A marked impression once she made upon a Zulu from Madame Lulu. And every morning he would be
down underneath the bamboo tree,
awaiting there his love to see. And then to her.
Find my hat anywhere.
Your hat? Oh, Esther! Have you seen Mr. Truitt's chapeau? I seem to have seen it somewhere. Excuse me just a minute. It was lovely having you, Mr. Truitt. I hope you'll drop in frequently.
Thank you, Miss Rose.
Here's your hat. It was right where I left it.
Thank you. Well, good night. And thank you for your neighborly hospitality.
Bonsoir, Mr. Truitt. Coming up, S? Presently, Rose. After all, someone has to escort our guests to the door. All right, but don't forget, you have to get your beauty sleep.
Well, I guess I'd better be going.
You haven't far to go.
No, I haven't at that, have I? Good night.
We're all going to the fairgrounds Friday. Will you be joining us?
I'd like to, if baseball practice doesn't run too late.
Please come. A gentleman shouldn't turn down a lady's request.
I guess not, Miss Esther. Well, good night.
Mr. Truitt?
Yes, Miss Esther?
This is an untoward request, but would you mind accompanying me throughout the house while I turn off all the lights? I'm afraid of the dark.
Sure. That's the least a man can do for his charming hostess.
It's certainly dark in here with all the lights off.
It certainly is.
I have to turn them off everywhere. the stairwell, the dining room, everywhere.
Well, shall we do the dining room now?
Yes.
Da 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 da.
Say, that sure is nice perfume.
Oh, do you like it?
Uh-huh.
It's essence of violets. I save it for special occasions.
Exactly the kind my grandma uses.
I'll just turn off this last one.
Hadn't we better leave something on for lunch?
I'll just turn it down low.
Gosh, Miss Esther, I hope I'm not being presumptuous, but you don't need any beauty sleep.
What a nice compliment.
How does it go?
How does what go?
Over the banister leans a face, tenderly sweet, and beguiling, while below her with tender grace, he watches the picture smiling. A light burns dim in the hall below, nobody sees them standing, saying good night again soft and low, halfway up through the landing. He's bewitched by her eyes abrow, tender and full of meaning, and by the loveliest face in town, over the banister leaning.
This has been a wonderful evening. I'll never forget it.
You will come Friday, won't you?
I'll try my darndest, Miss Esther. And you know something else?
What's that?
You've got a mighty strong grip for a girl. Good night.
Good night, neighbor.
I just adore him, so I can't ignore him. The boy next door.
Friday, the fairgrounds.
Trolley wait for no man.
Well, this is the end, and Dad promised you, John Hewitt, if you don't show up today, It'll be the end of you, baseball my foot.
With my high starch collar and my high top shoes and my hair high, high up on my head, I went to lose a jolly hour on the trolley and lost my heart instead. With his light brown derby and his bright green tie, he was quite the handsomest of men. I started digging, so I counted to ten, and I counted to ten again. Clang, 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 went the trolley. Ding, 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 went the bell. Ding, 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 went my heartstrings. From the moment I saw him, I fell. Chug, chug, chug went the motor. Bump, bump, bump went the brake. Thump, thump, thump went my heartstrings. When he smiled, I could feel the car shake. He tipped his hat and took a seat. He said he hoped he hadn't stepped up on my feet. He asked my name, I held my breath. I couldn't speak because he scared me half to death. Buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer. Plop, plop, plop went the wheels. Stop, stop, stop went my heartstrings. As he started to go, then I started to know how it feels when the universe reels.
Day was bright and the air was sweet. The smell of honeysuckle stuck to all my feet. So tiny sing, but couldn't squeak. In fact, she blossomed so she couldn't even speak.
Oh, buzz, buzz, buzz went the buzzer. Flop, flop, flop went the wheels. Started to leave, I took hold of his sleeve with my hand, and as if it were planned, he stayed on with me, and it was grand just to stand with his hand holding mine to the end of the line.
Halloween social.
I didn't want to go.
And what's your excuse?
Men are so tiresome.
Men are just a bother.
Not if you know how to handle them. When I was a young lassie back in Donegal, I forgot more about court than you two will ever know.
Oh, Katie, you just think the Irish are smarter than everybody else.
We got common sense, which seems mighty uncommon in this household. You two could use a touch of the Irish, if you ask me.
An Irishman is a funny guy, sometimes low and sometimes high, deceptive and evasive, poetic and persuasive. The lassies have a self-same knack, so they never have a lack of gentlemen hanging around. At least that's what I found. They charm them, disarm them with every feminine wile, and steal them from their sisters with brazen Irish guile.
It sounds as if when it comes to romance, a couple of Smiths wouldn't stand a chance. We ought to be Casey or Mulligan,
or Sullivan or McGilligan.
I know that isn't true. There are just a few simple things you ought to do. If the lad is slow to speak and quick to run away, if his wallet's empty when you give him the bill to pay, if he starts to panic when you mention wedding day, give him a touch of the marnie, his feet will leave the ground. Give him a touch of the shamrock and watch him curve around. If he says you're lucky knowing such a handsome gentleman, tell him that you're tired of him, you're giving him up for Lent. Do a bit of flirting just to throw him off the scent. Give him a touch of the blarney and set your little trap. Give him a touch of the shamrock, he'll fall into your lap.
He tried to kill me, but I screamed and ran away.
Agnes ran too, but she got away.
Let me see, honey. Mama won't hurt you. Oh, dear, she's lost a tooth.
Shall I call Papa?
Heavens no, what could he do?
He knocked me down, and he kicked me in the face.
Who did?
John Truitt.
John Truitt knocked you down?
He tried to kill me.
John Truitt would have hit a girl, least of all my sister.
Well, someone certainly hit her. Let's get her over to the light so I can see her bed.
Esther, is Judy all right?
Is Judy all right? A fat lie, who cares? If there's anything that I hate, loathe, despise, abominate, it's a bully. The next time you want to pick on a helpless little child, pick on someone your own size. And do you know what that was, Mr. Truitt?
What?
A touch of the Irish.
I'm not sure about this, Anna. It may need some stitches.
I hate to think what your father will do when he hears about this. He may strike that Truitt boy.
It's already been taken care of, Mother.
Tootie, I saw the whole thing. You should have brought what I did.
What happened?
When I got loose from John, I ran back. There was a big crowd with the policemen, and everybody was real mad. They said if they ever caught the boys that did it, they'd go to jail for sure.
If they ever caught the boys who did what?
Did the streetcar go off the track?
No, but the cable came off.
What in the world have you two been up to?
It was an old dress of Katie's. We stuffed it.
It looked like a big old dead body.
Well, I like that.
And we put it on the trolley tracks.
So when the motorman had to throw on the brakes, the streetcar would fly right off the tracks.
Agnes Smith, you might have killed dozens of people.
Oh, Rose, you're so stuck up.
Tootie, how did you hurt your lip?
The policeman saw Agnes and me putting the lady on the tracks. John Truitt saw us too and tried to make us go hide in the woodshed. I had to hit and scratch and bite until he let me go.
And?
Then I fell and hit my lip.
Sarah Mahalay Broadway Smith!
Yes?
You are the most sinful, deceitful, horrid person I ever knew. And from this day forward, I do not have a little sister.
Esther, there's time for that later. Right now, let's get her into the kitchen and do something about that lip.
Try not to be too mad, Es. After all, you didn't really believe that sweet John Truitt would hit a little girl, did you? Merciful heavens, John! John! Could you ever forgive me? I don't know how to apologize. I'm so ashamed. I actually believed her.
Believe who?
Tootie. She said that... Did I do that?
Uh-huh. And this.
John, I feel just awful.
Me too.
John, I know you don't feel about me the way I feel about you. No, it's all right. I've been outrageously forward, and it's clear that you're not really interested. If you could find it in your heart to believe this most unfortunate behavior on my part, then perhaps we could just be good friends. And neighbors.
Esther? How can I ignore the girl next door? I love her more than I can say. Doesn't try to please me, doesn't even tease me, and she never sees me. Esther, you're wonderful.
Oh, no, John. I'm not wonderful. I'm far from wonderful. One shoulder is higher than the other, and there are hundreds of other defects you can't even see. I mean, flaws in my character. I...
And I just adore her, so I can't ignore her. The girl,
the boy,
the joy next door.
long grip for a boy.
Here comes the
envelope.
I have to have two pieces of cake
because I'm recuperating.
If I ever catch you fibbing like that again, I'll give you something to recuperate from. Esther, is there something wrong with you?
Yes, Mother. I mean, no, Mother.
Esther's in love! Esther's in love!
Quiet, you two. You've caused enough trouble for one night.
It's just impossible to have a private life in this house.
Is this where the Smith family resides? It seems there's some ice cream needs to be delivered.
Ice cream? Papa, Agnes nearly got hit by a trolley. I knocked out my tooth, and it's been an absolutely perfect Halloween.
That's nice. I don't suppose you're ready for any more good news.
What? Tell us!
What is it, Lonnie?
The firm is sending me to New York.
Is that all? I think we can live without you for a while.
You'll be home by Thanksgiving, I hope. I've already ordered the turkey.
No, you don't understand. The firm is sending me to New York to take over the New York office. We're moving.
Moving to New York?
I don't believe it.
It's true. I'm to start the first of the year. We'll leave right after Christmas. I thought we'd like to spend one last Christmas in St. Louis.
I'll go pack. I'll start digging up walls.
Come back here. There'll be no packing or digging as yet. There's a great many things to discuss.
Why, Anna, I thought you'd be overjoyed.
Well, New York is such a big city. Not that St. Louis isn't big. It just doesn't seem very big out here where we live. What will the children do?
The same as they do here. Go to school, play, have their friends over.
What friends?
Yes, what friends?
The friends you'll meet in school.
But I don't go to school.
You will one day, if they'll take you.
All the people I care about are in St. Louis. I'm going to be a senior next year. And I've worked my whole life to be a senior.
You'll be a senior in New York.
I must say, Alonzo, you're very calm packing us off lock, stock, and barrel.
Anna, I have our future to think of. Lon's in Princeton, Rose may decide to go to college, and Esther, where's the money to come from?
Money. I hate, loathe, despise, and abominate money.
You also spend it.
And what about the World Fair? Just when St. Louis is about to become the center of the entire universe?
We can come back to see the fair. Most likely.
What about Katie and Grandpa? What about the chickens?
That's a minor detail we can figure out later.
So I'm a minor detail, am I?
I meant the chickens.
Oh, of course. Never mind what happens to your family at a time like this. Let's talk about the chickens.
Well, I suppose we're all a little excited. Let's talk this over tomorrow when everyone's had a chance to calm down. Now, how about some cake and ice cream? Agnes? Tootie? What's the matter with all of you? I never saw this family behaving so strangely.
Well, what did you expect, Alonzo? This little bombshell affects a lot of lives, not just your own. The children are upset. They love St. Louis.
St. Louis has been all right, but it's an old-fashioned kind of place. Let's expand and grow, let's up and go to a city with drive and class and style and grace. What is so rare as a day in New York? Who wouldn't hanker to stay in New York? On wide avenues, there's anything and everything a connoisseur might choose. People are friendly and fair in New York, helpful and kind everywhere in New York. Scintillating and smart, industrious, illustrious, and generous of heart. Busy and busy, the city's pretty pattern is. Of Manhattan is. People have vigor and pep in New York. York. And there's a spring in their step in New York. They'll welcome you to the full with all the thrills you can hold. Nothing is nicer than old New York.
What you call the truth isn't all the truth.
Skyscrapers, 10 stories tall in New York.
Fear of you, deaf, dumb, and blind. So when you shop, you better stop and leave your cash behind. I might cry, but I'll fade in New York. Soon be a lonely old maid in New York. With a John who viewed you seems dim. Cause our dreams and our schemes revolve around this.
We'll miss the ferry if we're there in New York. There's nothing like that anywhere in New York. The summer's pouring and cold, and winter's horrid and cold. Heaven protect us from mold.
Nothing is finer, no, not Argentina, Carolina, or China, or corn. Nothing is finer than home.
Winter's horrid and we'll miss the fair. Heaven protect us, this idea has wrecked us. Who wants to live in New York?
Well, all I can think of to mend matters is a hickory nut cake, as only Katie can bake it.
I'm taking my cat.
Where are you gonna keep her? Cooped up in some tenement?
I just can't read now. I just can't.
Goodness sakes, don't they have houses in New York?
Rich people have houses. People like us live in apartments.
Tenements!
I'd rather be poor if we only stay here. I'd rather go live with the orphans in the orphans' home.
And what about the World Fair?
Katie, this cake is light as a feather.
You can bake anything in that stove. They got little box stoves in tenements.
No, thank you, Papa. I'll have some later before bed.
It's your favorite, too, Esther.
No, Papa. I had too much at the ice cream parlor with...
I suppose you can handle this, huh, Grandpa?
Well, no. Yes.
Suppose you two are going to fight over the candy flower?
You can have the candy flower, Tootie. Middleton's backyard. Then, while she's walking around someday, I'll grab her by the leg.
But it'll take months,
and I'm not leaving until I'm finished.
Don't use that impertinent tone with your father.
I have some things to pack.
Me too.
I also.
Me too.
Me too.
How about a game of cribbage?
That's not long. I have some things to do.
Anna, if anyone asks for me, tell them I'm out celebrating my promotion alone. Aren't you afraid to stay here alone with a criminal? All I'm trying to do is earn more money to give my beloved family everything they deserve. And apparently that's worse than murder. I'm a fiend, ruining everyone's life.
Lonnie, it's not as bad as all that. It just came as a bit of a shock. If you think we should leave St. Louis, why, that's what we'll do.
I heard a bell long years ago. My young heart melted, and you're someone who should know. And still I love to tell of how I felt. I heard a bell.
It's good to hear you singing, Anna. It's been so long.
Wasn't it fun? Was
wonderful days of old lang syne. Wasn't it fine? Wasn't it fun? Ours is a romance second to none. Rain and sun, sun and rain, tears and laughter, joy and pain, sun and rain and sun, lifetimes and lifetimes rolled into one. And always such fun, always so fine, wonderful days of auld lang syne. And merry, merry, simply because your hand was in mine.
Princeton man home for Christmas?
Our last St. Louis Christmas.
Please, I don't want to talk about it.
Not only our last Christmas, but a Christmas Eve without a ball.
Lucille Ballard is a fool for not going to the ball with the handsomest man in town.
A girl has a right to dance with anyone she wants to. I just didn't ask her soon enough.
Everybody knows she's a typical Eastern snob.
Look who's talking. Soaking around the house because Warren isn't taking you to the ball.
Rose, I have to admit, it's partly your fault.
My fault? Warren asked you twice to go to the ball with him, and you kept him dangling.
Dangling?
You did, Rose.
It's so unfortunate that Lucille arrived in St. Louis just when Warren was beginning to feel that you were not taking him serious.
I wouldn't go to the dance with Warren Sheffield if he were the last man in St. Louis.
Yes, you would.
This is what I call the real Christmas spirit. You two have been at each other's throats since this vacation began. Alonzo Smith, did it ever occur to you that you might take your sister to the dance?
What?
Is there anything wrong with going with your own brother
and be the laughingstock of St. Louis?
Well, thank you very much.
Katie's right. This is our last Christmas in St. Louis, and it'd be tragic if either of you missed the ball.
It's all right for you to talk. You have a date. A real one.
Even if I didn't have a date with John Truitt, which I have, I'd be delighted to go with my own brother.
Then that settles it.
Wait a minute. What's that got to do with this?
Well, if you two won't go with each other, I won't go either.
You two ought to be ashamed, wrecking your poor sister's Christmas.
Rose, I'd be willing. I mean, glad to.
You would, Lon?
Sure, I was going to ask you anyhow.
Thank goodness that's settled.
And you two will have the best time of anyone. You won't have to be polite to each other.
I could just strangle that Lucille Ballard.
Why?
Don't you see? This is all her fault, accepting an invitation from your beau.
You're right, Ess. It is her fault.
I know. We'll give that Lucille an evening she'll never forget.
How?
By being ever so thoughtful and filling out her dance card for her.
What?
With the names of our city's most eligible young men.
Who?
Clinton Badger.
Clinton Badger? Ess, he's not.
Yes, you wicked thing, you wicked wonderful thing.
What about Pee-wee Drummond?
And Sidney Purvis.
Yes, this is divine, simply divine.
We'll give that Lucille a taste of St. Louis hospitality.
Boyfriend headed this way.
Who?
Someone who looks a lot like John Truitt.
Rose, Agnes, you can help me pick out my jewelry for tonight.
Do I have to?
John!
S, I'm afraid.
afraid I'm bringing bad news.
Oh no, what is it?
It's just awful. I can't take you to the dance tonight.
Your aunt? The hospital?
No, my tuxedo at the tailor's. Basketball practice ran late, and when I got to the store, there was a sign in the window, closed.
Then find the tailor and get him to open the shop.
All I know is his name is Jones, and he lives somewhere in St. Louis.
Jones? That's just as bad as Smith. Could you borrow someone else's?
Everyone who owns a tuxedo is going to the ball.
What about your father's?
That was my father's.
This is ghastly.
S, I'm sorry. Would you like to go somewhere else tonight?
No. I better stay home and do some packing. We leave for New York in just a few days.
I know. And this is a fine going away present I'm giving you. You must really hate me.
Oh no, John. I don't hate you. I just hate basketball.
Did something happen with John?
He can't take me to the dance.
But why?
His father's tuxedo is locked up.
That's horrible. But Lon can take the both of us.
You don't think I'm going to the smartest ball this season with my own brother, do you?
Well, I like that. I'm going with him.
Well, that was different. You didn't have a date.
Neither of you.
Well, I had one.
If Lon's good enough to take me, he's good enough to take you, too.
One sister going with her brother's been done, but two sisters would make the family look ridiculous. I won't do it.
We'll see what Mama has to say about that.
Dear Esther, as you know, eavesdropping is my favorite pastime.
Oh, Grandpa.
Now. You know, with your hair down like this, you're the very image of your grandma. I remember the first dance I took her to. Her father said to be home by 10:30, and she was crying, just like you are now.
Sorry. You must think I'm an awful baby.
Oh, no. You go right on ahead. It isn't often a pretty girl has a real legitimate reason to cry. A funny thing. With all this packing, I just took my tuxedo out of the mothballs yesterday. Looks pretty good, too.
Grandpa, are you offering to lend it to John?
I would do it in a minute, my dear. If it would fit him. I'm afraid your young man would look simply ridiculous in my tuxedo. But you know, a suit's like a man. Less to step out once in a while with a pretty dress. So, if you're...
Grandpa, are you inviting?
Of course I am.
Oh, Grandpa, you are so wonderful. I'm going to the dance with the handsomest man in town.
You can tell everybody that I'm an old flame.
My best.
I'll give you the rest of the evening to figure it out. Hello,
Bonnie. How are you, Warren?
Just fine, thank you. This is Esther Smith.
Esther, I've been most eager to meet you.
You have?
I just know we'll be friends. And you must be Grandpa Profiter. You're one of my favorite people.
We've met perhaps in another life.
Lon has spent hours singing your praises.
I can understand any young man wanting to spend hours with you singing on any subject.
S, we've been talking and...
Oh, yes, Rose, I'm sure you have. I hope you don't mind, Miss Ballard.
Oh, please, call me Lucille.
All right, Lucille. I hope you don't mind, but Rose and I have taken the liberty of filling out your dance card for you.
How thoughtful! Esther, I'm so thrilled about your moving to New York.
You are?
We'll have such fun. You must let me give you your first party. You will, won't you?
Well, I'm not sure. Lucille and I have been talking, and she suggested that Warren and I be partners for the evening. But I thought that you were gonna... It seems Long has found a partner, too. What about the other...
So, Miss Smith, what's this about Miss Bower's dance card?
Oh, I must have mislaid it.
Try looking behind your back.
Oh, here it is.
Clinton, Badger, Pee-wee, Drummond, Sidney Purvis. This isn't a dance card. It's a sentence to hard labor.
Lucille, may I have this dance?
I don't know. We'll have to see if you're on my card. Oh, Esther?
That's my card. Here. That one's yours.
Why, Lon, you're my first partner.
Miss Esther, where's this Miss Boo-Boo Ballard you put me down for? I'm ready.
Oh, Clinton, I hope you don't mind. I'm taking all of her partners tonight.
Mine? Wow-wee! Quentin Badger gets to dance with Esther Smith? Wow-wee!
Pee-wee Drummond? Oh no!
Sidney Purvis? It just gets better.
Let's hear it for Esther Smith and Sidney Purvis.
Quentin Badger.
Come on, gang. Let's do the dance all the college kids are doing. No matter what jinx is bothering you, I have a magic charm that will do a miracle. A first-class miracle. No abracadabra, no evil eye, no hocus pocus needed for my idea. It's a real panacea. At Princeton and at Yale, they're sure they found a very simple cure. When life could not be any drearier, what makes dispositions cheerier? Dancing, dancing a banjo. When you're so low you hit the floor, I guarantee you're gonna soar. You'll fly like a bird in the sky. If you do the banjo, girls will swarm like bees around the flower. You're sure to weather every storm and so if you're hoping things will happen, keep poking, tap, and finger snap, cause all that you have to do is dance. Blinkety-plunk, plunkety-blink, she'll be in your arms, that's wings, oh wings. So whirl round, reverse and then twirl round, for each guy and girl round. Tapping, finger snapping, cause all that you have to do is dance. Clinkety-plunk, plunkety-plink, she'll be in your arms as quick as a wing. So whirl round, reverse and then twirl round, for each guy and girl round, keep dancing the banjo. Again.
Esther, don't cry. I never would have asked you if I thought it would make you unhappy.
Unhappy? John, I've pictured this moment hundreds of times. Hundreds. And I've always planned exactly how I'd act. I never planned to cry.
At least you didn't laugh.
Laugh?
I've never asked a girl to marry me before. I probably didn't say it right.
Oh no, John. No one could have said it more beautifully.
Will you, Esther? Will you marry me?
Of course I will, John!
Do you realize I might have lost you? Two more days and you would have been gone.
Let's not even think about it.
Now when you go to New York, it'll be with your husband, and your folks can show us the town. Come on, let's go in and tell them.
Oh, John, I mean, couldn't just the two of us know about it tonight?
You're not changing your mind. You do feel it's the right thing to do, don't you?
Yes. Yes.
I don't need to be an engineer. College takes too long anyhow.
You'd have to give up going to college?
What difference does it make? I can get a job right away and support you in style.
But John, I don't want you to.
And we can't let anybody talk us out of it. After all, we're of age. Practically.
John?
Yes?
Even if I were to go to New York, we can still be engaged.
Do you think so?
I know so. Being away for a little while will just make it, sweeter when we're finally together.
Esther, you're about the most, you are, I still can't believe it.
When we met, the spring had turned to summer. The roses were in blossom, I recall. Later on with summer, nearly autumn, I knew I'd fallen long before the fall. Autumn has turned into winter, so spring can't be very far away. hand I have led, a head can be turned in a year, in a month, in a day. Songs are for singing, bouquets are for greeting, hopes are for clinging to you. Wheels of fortune are for spinning, and games are for winning. Tunes are for humming, guitars are for strumming, dreams are for coming true, and you are for loving, and loving, and loving, and loving, by someone just as wonderful as you. And so I wonder if I do.
Songs in your voice, there's a clearness in your touch, such a nearness in your eyes, there's a song too.
Bye.
be together.
Turn the Lord allow. Until then, we'll have to muddle through somehow. So have yourself a merry
about leaving St. Louis. Say goodnight to Papa, dear. I'm sorry, Papa.
Anna! Anna! Lon! Esther Rose! Grandpa Tootie! Agnes Katie! Everybody, come down here!
What is it, Lonnie? I think there's a fire.
Quiet, all of you! I have something to say. We're not moving to New York. And I don't want any arguments. We're staying right here. We're going to stay here until we rot.
We haven't rotted yet, Lonnie.
What will you say to Mr. Fenton?
That I've changed my mind. I'm a junior partner, not a puppet on a string. And if they don't like it, well, then that's just too bad. Because we're staying right here. Why, St. Louis is headed for a boom that'll make your head spin. The trouble with all of you is that you can't appreciate what you've got under your very noses. The grass is always greener in someone else's.
Smith!
Warren?
We can't go on like this anymore. We're going to get married at the earliest possible opportunity, and I don't want to hear any arguments. That's fine. I love you. Merry Christmas.
Merry
Christmas.
Anna, who's that boy?
He's a very fine young man, Lonnie. We'll talk about it later.
I've never seen Warren so excited.
He's liable to leave on his honeymoon without Rose.
Rose is getting married. Then maybe she should open her presents earlier.
You little faker. It's your presents you're after.
Presents!
Good heavens, I'd completely forgotten. It's Christmas.
Oh, Papa, you've given us the best present in the whole world.
Merry Christmas, sweetheart.
Merry Christmas, Papa.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, Papa. I've liked you ever since you came into this family.
Thank you.
Just picture the opening night, pavilions exploding with light. With banners unfurled, we will welcome the world to this frolicking sight.
Oh, Tootie, you better tell the motor man where you want to go.
This expedition. Esther, Rose, your fellas are here.
Seen electric lights outdoors.
There's never been anything like it.
And we don't have to get here on a train.
Or stay in a hotel.
It's all right here in our own hometown.
Grandpa, they'll never tear it down, will they?
Well, they better not.
I still can't believe it. Right here where we live. Right here in St. Louis.
In St. Louis.